100.
Gravitational pull, 1.073.
Danger, danger. Force level building to fatal intensity.
Out, it's on casters. The casters are sunk into that foam that drops down about an inch. So you're gonna have to get two guys, grab it from here and down there, lift it up and easily pull it out, because these bands, these treads, are actually rubbing on that foam. And if you try to pull it out, you could break the treads. Okay? Okay, when I'm packing your torso, be careful, we put the core, the internal core, in the middle of the torso, but it's not attached. So when you pull up the torso, it's gonna take two guys, one on each side, lift by these hooks. These are welded metal hooks, they'll be fine. You lift it up, just be careful about, and do not grab the neon, and do not grab in here, but you can grab here and pick it up straight over the core, and when, that should be it. Just be careful though with the core. You cannot take the core out this way. The torso has to come off first, okay? To connect the torso electronics to the internal boards, we have two plugs, and two plugs only that are needed to tether from the internal boards to your torso. And that's plugs two, which is a 5-conductor, and plug six. It's supposed to be a six. Which is a 6-conductor. Now, either you can have two people raise the robot and hold it up, or, and then a third person plug him in, or get a table like we've done. Put your torso on the table. Lay the torso down with the arms off, of course. Put the torso down. And you'll see, here's your two plugs. Plug number six, plug number five. Sorry, plug number two. Plug number six, plug number two. There's a plug here, number five, that if it becomes undone, just plug it in. That powers the lights for all these bays. Okay, so take your 5-conductor, which is plug two, plug it together. Then take your 6-conductor plug, which is number six, plug it together. They do fit really snug, okay? That's it for tethering the torso to the internal electronics. Once you have your torso connected to the internal boards and you have your power cord, main power cord, plugged into an outlet, you want to test the robot out before you put them all together. So have your torso being held up by a padded table. You're gonna need to reach into the tape bay, open up the vents. Let's see it. There's two switches. There's a switch to turn on the main and another switch to turn on the neon. Have those two switches on. Then the next switch is a power switch, which is right there. That's switch number one. That switch is the power supply. You have to turn that on. Once that's on, everything comes up. Robot will say this. Also notice the radio doesn't power up right away. That's on a timer. It powers up after 40 seconds, which you'll see it come on at the end of this speech.
Who turned out the lights? Who turned out the
Once the radio comes on, you're going to need to go ahead and set it for the first time to the CD section. So you're going to want to find CD, which the radio is not ready yet. It's still going through. Okay, now it's at demo mode. So there's HD radio, FM, USB, CD. Once you get CD, hit enter. I think I missed it. All right, yeah, I got to start over again. CD, enter. Then it'll come on. There's your climatics unit. And then it'll start talking. Okay, the next thing you want to test is the remote. This four-channel remote, A, B, C, and D, is for controlling the torso's movement left and right, and then for controlling the bubble head up and down. Now, A is for the torso to move to the robot's right. B is to move it to the left. Now, you don't want the torso going all the way around. It won't. It'll get stuck before you do. So just give it short movements. Hold it in, let it go. Hold it in, let it go. Same thing goes with the bubble. Now, very important on the bubble. This bubble actuator that was bought when you bought the robot from Ken is too long. So when you go to lift the bubble, just do it in short bursts. Do not hold it, make it go all the way up. You will damage your upper section, head section of the robot. It'll rip out and tear up. But for this, right now, you're just testing to make sure the actuator works. So give it a quick burst, just a push, let it go, push, let it go, push, let it go. That's all you need for that. Okay, that works. Next, we're going to put the torso on top of the tread section. All right, so when you go to put your torso on top of the tread section, you have these bolts sitting here and one missing. The one that's missing is because of the tape base sits right there. So make sure that the one missing is facing front on the robot. It's gonna take two people to lift this torso up and put it on. So we gotta pick the torso up and get it mounted over these studs. So Rob, let's, you grab it. Get this. Do not grab the torso by the vents. Okay, turn it towards me. That cord is in the way. There we go. Now, you gotta turn it this way. Okay. Balance it while I find the holes. Gotta go more this way. Okay. There, now it's on. You will not need to bolt it down. It's not necessary, don't worry about bolting it. You know, you're not traveling or taking anywhere. And reach in, make sure the cord is out of the way. Sorry. Now, this cord goes to connect the bubble.
Let's see the cord.
Okay, it's right here, this cord right here. Okay. What we need to do next, now that we have the torso on, we've got to mount the head. And we'll come back and I'll show you how to mount the head. You got your bubble extender with the nuts. We already have taken a still picture to show you how to put it on. It goes on the inside of the robot.
On. Okay. I am a general utility non-theorizing environmental robot. Robot model B9. Designed and computerized as a mechanized electronic aid for Earth voyagers engaged in astral expeditions. Where am I? What happened? Who turned out the lights? Who turned out the lights?
Okay, once you have the extender on, then we're going to put the bubble on and connect it to this cord. These two in. This is number 9. The only one that's like this. Once you plug it in, get it out of the way. Now it's working. Test it, but only do short presses, very half-second presses, on the bubble. See how it moves when it's not mounted? Okay, we're going to have to take some wing nuts, Rob, and install the wing nuts through the arms. So reach up here, put one wing nut on there. There's a total of three. With those wing nuts in place, if you extend that rod too much, you're going to break the collar. So again, it's just to show that bubble goes up and down, but not a lot. That rod will go 4 inches, and you don't want that. You got both on? Up, down. That's all you should do is like this. You go too high, and it's going to start separating the rubber, and it's going to want to pull on this, and it'll get broken. So again, C makes it go up, D makes it go down. C, D. And if it starts spinning, you can just reach in, turn him. Now he's facing front. Up, down. Okay, now we're going to do the arms. Okay, one. Go in there with a plate and a nut. I'll hold the robot. You get this one lined up in both of them. Really should do this with the power off.
Yes.
Let's turn it off. You can hear it. There. You dropped that plate. Hey, or we didn't say we were the brightest robot illusions.
I'm not so sure, Lenny.
You got the plate on.
I'm
the
getting bone. There.
No, but the plate fit.
Yeah.
Okay, on the second end, by the way, it doesn't matter which claw goes on which side, they're both the same side. Whether you put it this one here or you use it here, doesn't really matter. These are supposed to be facing the top if you want them that way, and on this one. So that one should be on this side, but, you know, again, Lenny, the latch. But okay, so now to access and get this one screwed down, you have to go through the left bay port in order to get your hand up here and put the plate on, okay? So Rob, go ahead and you put the plate on. I'll hold this up against there. Now the arms are both in place. You're going to use this port for the radio. This is where you access the CD. When it comes on. Let me wait till it comes on. It's going to take 40 seconds. So why don't you pause that. So that's where you access the CD. Okay, so that's the port to get to the CD. You hit the eject button. And there's the CD. This is Robot Ramblings Volume 1. You put it in, just place it in like any CD. You can close the vent by sliding it. So be careful, they're real touchy. Just slide it. Oops, there you go. Just slide it closed. You can still see the CD. And the remote will work through, pointing through the bay. Okay, the last thing we're going to show you, AG, come around here, is the tread section bottom. Just want to show you that we got the plate off and that there's nothing inside there. That's what it looks like without the plate. Right? It has 18 screws that have to go back on. We're going to put the plate on before we pack it up, but just wanted to show you that there was nothing inside here. You need to take the plate off if you have to replace the casters because they're bolting inside here on a plate. But it takes 18 screws to put the plate on and off.